Welcome to this video. Today, you're going to learn how to use ever and never. This is a question that a student had submitted, and it's a great question, so I'm happy to answer it for you. Of course, I'm Jennifer from JForrestEnglish.com, and this channel is dedicated to helping you feel confident speaking English in public so you can take your career and your life to the next level. Now, before we go any further, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon so you're notified every time I post a new lesson. Now, let's dive in with this video. Let's talk about how to use ever and never. You can think of ever as at least once or one or more times. That's ever. Now, never, you can think of this as zero times. Never, zero times, not once. Ever and never are commonly used in the present perfect, especially in question form. So let's take a question in the present perfect. Have you been to Banff? Have you been to Banff? Now, in the present perfect, it's extremely common. In fact, it even sounds more natural to me to use the word ever. Have you ever been to Banff? Now, we add ever to present perfect questions because they're asking about life experience. And remember, it means at least once. So if you've been to Banff at least once or more in your life, then you can answer yes to the question. If you've been to Banff zero times, then you'll say no. I've never been to Banff. So notice ever, we use it in the question form, but we don't use it in the positive answer. As a positive answer, I would just say, yeah, I've been to Banff once, twice, three times, four times, and I'd give my answer. So let me ask you a question in the present perfect. Have you ever been skydiving? So, have you ever been skydiving? You can put your answer in the comments below, and also, why don't you ask us a have you ever question and make it a fun and interesting question. Put that in the comments below. Now, although ever and never are very commonly used in the present perfect, we can also use them in the present simple. Never is very commonly used in the present simple. So remember, it means zero times. And in the present simple, we're asking about routine actions. So we're asking about the frequency of actions you do. So it would be very common to say never for certain actions. For example, I could say, I never work out at night. I never work out at night. So this is not part of my daily routine. It takes place zero times in my daily routine. We can use ever in question form in the present simple, although it's much less common than it is in the present perfect. But I could ask you, do you ever work out at night? Now, in this case, I'm asking you about the frequency of this action in your daily routine. So as a reply, you're just going to use an adverb of frequency and say, oh, I sometimes work out, I usually work out, I frequently work out, I rarely work out, and you're going to give me your answer. Remember, if it's zero times, then you use never. I never work out at night. So what about you? Do you ever work out at night? You can put your answer in the comments below, and at the same time, why don't you ask your fellow students a question using do you ever? So remember, this is a present simple question. You're asking about the frequency of that action in their daily routine. So now you know the difference between ever and never, and remember to do all the practice in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and of course, subscribe. And if you're a busy professional who's serious about improving your English speaking skills so you can take your career and your life to the next level, then I want you to go to my website, jforrestenglish.com. There, you'll find a free case study where you'll learn how to feel confident speaking English in public so you can impress your boss and clients with your message in only 30 days. To get your free case study, simply click the button, enter your name and email, and you'll get instant access to the case study. And until next time, happy studying! Just a little bonus for you. Sometimes native speakers will combine never and ever together to be really dramatic or add emphasis. For example, I could say, I would never, ever go skydiving. And that's just being very dramatic about the statement so you know how strong I feel about it. So that's just a bonus expression for you. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.